going to say hi to Tawny Peaks real fast. She's been at home. Tawny.
Hey, good morning.
You're talking to Opie and Anthony, Jim Norton, and Stephen Pearson from Rat.
Nope, the former Rat vocalist dude.
What's up, Tawny?
Oh, not much. Just getting up, getting motivated for the day.
Oh, just wakey-wakey.
Well, actually, I've been up for probably about 45 minutes trying to get some stuff done around the house, but...
Okay, and?
Where are you? Are you in New York, or as I call it, the Big Apple?
No, actually, I'm in Detroit.
Ooh. Detroit. What does a porn star do in the morning when she wakes up?
Masturbate. Not a porn star, number one.
Opie.
Told you, Opie.
Not a porn star.
Can you
please,
with me.
Can you please clarify with for Opie, please?
Yes.
What you've been saying it all morning.
What are you?
Actually, I'm a mom and housewife now.
Yeah, a mom and housewife, Tawny Peaks. Well, not a porn star,
you.
Tawny
no,
Peaks.
No, back in the day, I did the cover Playboy Voluptuous Vixen in 98.
Oh, nice. Oh, you never did porn?
No, I never did hardcore porn. No, I did not.
No.
I did do pictures for magazines.
Right.
But a lot of people...
Voluptuous Vixen videos all...
Wouldn't that be considered...
R-rated.
Wouldn't that be considered porn, though, or no?
I guess... In a sense, yes, but in a sense, no, because when you think porn, you think hardcore.
Yeah, there were a few videos with you in them, though, right?
But yeah, like Voluptuous Vixens. I mean, it's R-rated. You see that kind of stuff on HBO.
Yeah, so it's like a softcore, they call it.
Exactly.
And it was a lot of girl-on-girl?
No, actually.
No?
Mostly myself.
Just yourself?
Just doing painting, doing stupid things. I really didn't get into the video part of it.
Painting? Mm-hmm. Oh, that's cool.
So we shouldn't call you a slut, obviously.
No, you should not.
Yeah, I know.
Of course not.
A lot of people confuse like what softcore is with hardcore. There's definitely that distinction because some people will make it.
There is a major distinction.
Yeah.
Like, get some coffee in your ass.
Like you didn't show the pink, right?
Pink in like pink. It's a song off Social Intercourse.
Get over it already.
Yeah, get over
it.
I try so hard to keep this show on the right track, Tawny. And I get people like Opie and Jimmy, Steve, everybody just making problems for me when I'm trying to conduct an interview.
That's true. Peaks. We don't have you on the phone to talk politics. Let's be honest with each other.
No, I thought you wanted to know what was going on with eBay.
I guess.
No. Well, yeah, definitely you did sell your implants on eBay, right?
Yes, I did.
And a lot of people said that, well, that's kind of an odd decision to make. I mean, do you feel that those people have some kind of like, you know.
What?
Yeah, I agree.
What the hell are you... What are you going to do with those?
It was an odd decision to make. You're absolutely correct. The way it went down was my husband and I were watching Jay Leno on a Friday night, and he had some odd things sold on eBay. Mm-hmm. Well, needless to say, the next day I was cleaning up some cupboards because we moved in the past couple of years, and I came over across with a box of implants in it, and my husband, I brought it up to his attention in the office. I'm like, look, what I found.
Wow. So, well,
he was like, he thought he tossed those when we moved. And I thought he did too. And then we started remembering about what was on eBay the night, or what was on Dayton the night before. And I said, do you want to put them on there? And he said, no, we're going to buy them. I said, oh, yeah, well, we'll put a high reserve on it. And if they do, we'll take the kids away for the weekend.
Gotcha.
If they don't, we'll just toss them.
Fascinating.
So that's how it happened.
Listen, you sold a part of your body, technically.
No, it wasn't a part of my body.
It was in your body for a long time, and it made you some good money. I would think selling your implants would be
sick.
Dare I say a slutty thing?
Kinda.
Will you guys get over the slutty thing, or I will hang up the phone.
Yeah,
hang up the phone because
I'm sorry.
My question was, eBay has a thing about selling like body parts and stuff like that. Was there a problem with that because they said that was a body part or no? Because eBay does have a weird thing about you can't sell like bones or anything like that.
Right.
Well, actually, the implant, in order for me to take it out of the hospital, had to be sterilized. I mean, they reuse tools. They're sterilized all the time. So it was completely, it was fine.
Uh-huh.
How big did the implants make your tits?
Mammaries.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
How big do the implants make your tits?
The mammaries. The mammal.
They basically enhanced them after I had my son because they drooped. So I had the implants put in to pop them back up again. It wasn't really to make them much bigger. It was just to...
So when did you stop doing any type of nude modeling?
97.
97 was the last time, and then you stopped because of your child?
No. I stopped because I wanted to get out of that industry.
So 97, you stopped selling your body.
Actually,
for money, you know. So at 97, you decide to live the clean life and stop being a slut.
That's not the way to put it or anything, Opie.
So since 97, you haven't been too whorish.
Enough.
Hello? I knew she'd hang up.
Boy, get a cup of coffee in you first before you call.
I knew she was hanging up. There was no way. I couldn't be good enough good cop, and that's no. To keep her on the fucking phone.
My memory's my best.
Who is she kidding? And as soon as someone says on this show, don't do that or I'm going to hang up.
You ever hear your show and hang up on you because me and my memory's.
Do we have the Tommy Lee phone call? We got to play that for Stephen Piercy.
Yeah?
We have that, right?
Tommy.
Is it short?
He's my gladiator buddy from way back then. We had a street gang called the Gladiators back in 1980.
Really?
When we first hooked up. Yeah, me,
Jimmy was
Vince.
In the Lords.
The Lords. Me, Vince, and Nikki. Nikki was Leader Six. Robin was King Crosby. Vince was Field Marshal. I was Rat Leader, and it was a good thing.
He was Jimmy Robinson.
Yeah.
Right on. I wore a cape, and Helen helped me.
Why don't we take a break? They're going to find the Tommy Lee.
There we go.
All righty.
What are we going to talk to Tawny Peaks about?
What did she want to talk about?
That she sold her implants.
And that she's trying to wake up.
Who cares that she sold her implants?
I forgot the amount, but it was some kind of...
And I did it because my sagging was sagging... Yeah.
Great.
My son sagging to... See what I did?
I'm going to hang
eBay.
Up.
So. Curse, we gotta break into this. Unbelievable interview because we have Tawny Peaks back on the phone.
Oh God,
Tawny.
Hello.
What was the problem?
First,
well, you guys, I'm not in the business anymore.
I understand.
Secondly, I'm not here to plug anything for myself.
Uh-huh.
I was just doing a favor because I was asked to do it.
Cool.
Give you guys a call.
I
you were interested in eBay.
Tawny, I would like to apologize on behalf of the program. I, as I said before, I try to keep things reined in, and there are people here that just won't.
You're calling in as a favor?
Yes, she is, and it was really good.
Yeah,
how much did you get for the implants
favor.
On eBay?
It was like $16,700.
Having like Sylvester Stallone call in as a favor,
he might be doing that.
And we're gunning for that though.
Why is Tawny Peaks calling us a favor?
She's being very nice about it. I appreciate
it. People asking me to call in.
It was nice.
Right.
A favor.
I was doing it because I was gonna tell you guys about the Golden Palace Casino.
That makes us sound quite desperate that you would be the one calling in as a favor.
That isn't
not as a favor to you.
Special.
Right. It's not for you.
Is a favor.
Not you.
I was getting their name out there because they were quite generous.
Right. Well, who gets the favor?
Well, it's a Golden Casino.
Golden Palace.
Golden
Casino,
Palace Casino kind of hooked you up and said, look, we'd like you to call in, give a few mentions, talk to the guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, they said that you guys would like to talk with me. They asked if I would do it. I said, sure, I would do it.
They bought your implants?
What a great company they are and how they actually... asked me if I was going to donate some of the money, and I said, yes, I am. And I found some research on them, and they donate money to the
class. Yeah. They bought your implants?
Will you guys stop?
They bought your implants?
They did, I think.
Did you get new ones?
No, I don't have anything.
They're all flat now?
Is that a medical problem when they're taken out, Tawny?
No, actually, I had a breast reduction.
Oh, you did?
So they're not saggy and flat?
No.
They're not pancake eggs?
No. Tawny, I dated a girl one time who had implants, and she had them on the outside of the muscle, which caused a problem for her. Do you, like, with certain implants because of like, the way they're put in?
I never really had any problems, no.
It's a metal to
train. I'm very fortunate that I didn't have them in that long. Oh. Got to remember, I was only in business from 94 to 97.
Are you going back into porn?
Definitely not.
So shucks.
Did you have a bad experience in the business?
I never belonged there in the first place, to be honest.
Why is that? How did that
happen? It wasn't in me.
Because she didn't.
That was because hundreds of times.
Yeah, right.
Because she didn't want to take one in the poop chute.
Ooh, the back, the backside.
It's really a nice place you have.
All right, guys. Well, it was nice talking to you.
Wait. Stephen Piercy from Rat Fame. He's not in the band anymore. He had a question for you.
Well, I think it was answered the other way.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
I think she did answer it, right? He wanted to know if you still had the implants, but you said no.
Oh, that was it, Steve?
Yeah, I mean, if they were just, like, flat, because you know how they Yeah, you know, like soiled eggs kind of gig.
But they're not. She said that they take care of that.
Oh, that's
good. She had a reduction.
Yeah, they take care of that.
And, Tawny, what do you do now?
I am a housewife and a mom. I have beautiful children. I have a great life. Life is good. I gave up the business when I was actually on the top with my Playboy cover coming out, and I could have made a whole bunch more money, but I was blessed because I stopped when I did.
Yeah.
How many cots do you have? How many kids?
Three. I know, you guys wish I was more exciting, but I'm sorry I'm not.
No, you're all right. We're taking a look at some nude pictures of you. You look very nice.
Back in the day.
Or used to, obviously. This is probably quite a long time ago now.
Do you do you run a website?
Holy mackerel.
No, I don't.
Fuck me hard.
Damn.
Either fuck me.
All right.
So
you guys have a great day. I can hear what's going on there.
But
very Tawny, sexy pictures.
How is this website able to run with your name?
Beautiful.
Because I see Tawny.
Ooh, that's good acting.
I see it's a website.
When I did my photo shoots, I had to sign rights off to the photographer, and that's why everything's done in my name. I have nothing to do with it.
You don't get paid from these?
Absolutely
not. No residuals?
Wow.
Nothing.
They could put your nude pictures up there, and you don't get anything from
them. That's what happens when you're young and stupid, guys. I'm sure you've all experienced something like that. Right?
Yeah, you sign. They're all,
no,
all these pictures
never
are on eatabullet.com. People are just going there and checking them out.
Sorry?
There's a website called eatabullet.com.
Yeah.
And it's like all these nude pictures.
I have no idea.
It's also at Stephen-Piercy.com.
Yeah.
Your pictures are all over that.
Everywhere.
You sign them away, though, right? You sign away the rights. You don't get any cash.
I'm going to sell my I'm going to sell my breast implant.
I got paid for the pictures when I did them, signed them off. If I wouldn't know any better.
Is that why you quit the business? Because you didn't like the business? What did you...
Exactly.
You didn't like the business?
So you,
no, not really.
What made you get into it in the first place if you said you didn't belong in it?
You guys really don't want to hear that story.
I kind of
do.
Don't. That's what I want to hear, is how you got into that business.
Because I was a very insecure woman, or I should say young girl.
How old were you when you got in?
21.
Okay. 21. You're 21. You're insecure about yourself? And
yes, I had a child who had a disability, and I was basically... told if
that's a good
I
excuse.
Cared all about
oh, Jesus.
By the
Wait.
Like I said, it's a long story. It's not something you really want to hear.
No, it's kind of that. But that's the interesting part. This is interesting.
Your child, you were trying to take care of your child. What was the matter?
He had to have open heart surgery and he has Down syndrome. That is nothing.
That's terrific.
Stop that.
That's terrific.
Excuse me?
I don't know. Somebody is hitting buttons here that they probably shouldn't play. Tawny, so you're insecure.
What was that?
So you're insecure, and you have.
Yeah, I was an insecure woman or young girl at the time, and I was led into something I didn't want to be in.
By somebody that was like domineering, or somebody that was.
Yes, actually, and then I finally came into my own. And when I came into my own, I said, "This is not for me."
Do you still have contact?
And then I cut all ties.
You still have contact with the person that got you into the business?
Yes, and that person is very apologetic. So
really?
Oh, about having led you in that direction.
Exactly, because it was a mistake on that person's part.
Is it your husband, Tawny?
What was that?
Is it your husband that got you into the business?
No. I'm not going to tell anybody's names or who it was over the radio.
Just like a relationship. What was it, a friend?
It was a relationship, exactly.
Oh, yeah? Oh, okay.
Uncle Toucher or...
No.
Oh.
No, nothing like that.
Well, the listeners, I mean, they're instant feedbacking, and they're assuming that you were touched by an uncle. That's all.
Well,
no,
touched by an angel.
So you were trying to raise money just to kind of make ends meet, and this is the kind of direction you went to.
You're absolutely right.
You look back at you, I kind of wish I didn't go in that direction.
Don't lie to me.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Yeah. Oh, wow. Wow, that's something.
That's
see?
Brilliant.
That's the kind of stuff that I wanted to hear. I don't really. You know, care about the implants and how much they were sold for or anything. It's that inner story of how you got into this business.
Well, that inner story was a very naive, insecure young girl and got led into something. And then I finally grew up, I guess, came into my own, realized what life was about. And it's not about that business. It's about family and positive, healthy relationships.
Yeah.
Of course it is.
Is it hard to keep intimacy, like, when stuff like that's going on, like when you go to work to come home and have intimacy? It's got to be like a real intimacy blocker, right?
I mean, you're talking in the past.
Yeah, no, I'm saying, like, I've talked to people in the business. They say it's hard to be in an intimate relationship when you're going off and having very unintimate, like, sex, and then you come back home, and it's hard to separate the two.
Well, I was never going off having sex anywhere.
Everybody, yeah. Everybody, yeah. Get into it, yeah. Get stoked, come on. Get retarded, come on. Get retarded, yeah. Get retarded.
Everybody!
That,
oui?
Do you think that a lot of people, like, one of the problems people who rail against the adult industry say is that a lot of people are kind of led mm-hmm. in a certain direction and kind of are misled about what the business is going to be. Did you
yeah.
find that happen with you?
Yes, absolutely.
Really? You had this impression that it was going to be one thing and it turned out to be something completely different?
A bunch
well,
of things.
No, actually, it just turned out not to be for me.
Are you,
exploitive.
Are you still a chubby woman these days? Or
chubby?
Thanks, actually.
Like when people want to see you naked at this point?
Average,
yeah.
Well, when you get out of the business, I guess, you know, life goes on.
Life does go on. Actually, life began.
Oh.
Seriously.
Did it really? You got a whole new outlook on life?
I have a wonderful outlook on life.
How relieved were you when you finally didn't have to go, like, when you finally moved on and said, let me close the chapter?
Well, it's like this. I have no shame. I have no guilt.
Right.
There you go.
I don't.
And why should you? That's right. You shouldn't.
No, I shouldn't, because what doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
Hey, did you make that up?
Yeah, I did.
That's
sure.
a good one.
Hey. You got that hanging on your wall at home?
With
no,
the cat holding on that says, hang in there, baby.
No, it's actually, I mean, it's like, did you have...
Were you walking in the sand with, like, two sets of...
Footprints.
And then also...
Yeah,
there was,
I love that one, too.
That
no,
is nice.
No,
one set of footprints and...
Sometimes when people perform, they get like a big head.
That's true.
And it squirts.
I'm sorry, I can barely hear you.
One set of footprints is really nice, like a woman's, and the other is this big fat mess of feet that are really much too wide for shoes. I don't understand it at all.
Me.
But it's an inspiring story.
Write a book. You should write a book.
You should write a book.
If anybody can go through what I went through and end up how I am, if I can do it, anybody can do it. It's a very inspiring story for people out there who think that they're stuck, that think that they're going to be pigeonholed,
yeah.
put into something category
that's a book.
Be stuck with for life. It's not true.
Have people approached you about a book or a movie about your life?
Quite a while ago, people were talking to me about it when I actually did a lot of talk shows.
Yeah.
Right when I was getting out of the business, I did the Maury Povich show, and I.
Oh, cool.
Helped
Maury.
Him. Oh, Maury is
what
good.
Happened to
Maury's
him?
Good.
Maury, he turned into Jerry Springer.
Is he still around?
You are not the baby's.
Let's
father.
Be honest. No,
you are not the baby's father.
Exactly. Prior to the not the baby father day.
Let's be honest. No one would read a book about this horse shit.
No, but I did some shows with them, and I was helping a lot of young girls who were. Lost on the show.
Oh, that's good. Like did they have the boot camp guy come out?
Yes, it was myself
yeah,
and him.
Of course they did.
Hey. He was bad cop, I was good cop.
The highlight of your career was a Maury Povich appearance.
That's not bad.
Not the highlight. It's just part of her life. She's helping people out.
Chicken head.
Are you trying to steer? You trying to steer people away from what you like the things you think that are mistakes that you made? You trying to just steer them kind of in out of that direction?
Yeah.
Yeah, I was trying to. Yeah, exactly.
She was the greatest piece of ass I've ever had, and I've had them all over the world.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I understand. Mm-hmm. Well, that's I find it
something
inspiring.
To be proud of, though. After the Progeria Kids segment, they rolled your fat ass out.
Oh, my God.
Feelings. Nothing more than feelings.
You goddamn try, and you have to put up with this.
That's one for the resume.
Ugh. She hung up again.
Someone a favor.
No,
she's right
I'm
there.
Here.
Don't hang up.
Hang up. It's cool.
I, for one, I'm sorry, and I for one, am. I like the story that you're telling.
When you think about
it is inspiring.
When you think about those days, are you cool with it, or are you?
It's sensitive sometimes.
I honestly don't think about those days, but if I do, I'm cool with it.
Do they get you downs?
No, they don't get me down at all.
Aroused?
No, they don't get me aroused. They're just a part of my life that's over.
You giggle, they do.
Yeah.
A anything lot of people else? Regret the past. They're downs in the dumps.
Yeah.
It's a good memory.
Like I said,
memory.
I don't regret anything. Yeah. I have no shame. I have no guilt. It's awesome.
Do you miss your boobs?
I got to tell you something. You had huge boobs. I'm on your website, TonyPeaks.com.
It's not her website. Somebody else is exploiting her name now. And
did you get really big implants so people wouldn't look at your face?
No. Very rude.
That's Opie, by the way, Tawny. And Opie is, I'm going to say it, a son of a bitch to people.
Fine.
I'm here trying to...
hold the fort down.
Get a little information. I am fascinated with the story. I find it inspiring, and someone like Opie really can't appreciate somebody maybe struggling and then emerging from it a better person, and I apologize for that.
I think it's a great, fantastic picture. That's actually a very beautiful picture.
A stronger, less
I like that.
Mamoretical.
Yeah. I like it.
You should learn how to use Photoshop for your family photos and for your past photos.
Anything else you're interested in as far as just being a mom, or is there anything else in your life that you're doing?
I work in radio and television.
You do radio and TV? Well, tell me a little bit about that. What do you do?
I worked before I had my daughter. I was working in a news station.
No, now.
Really?
Working at the assignment desk, and I was also
now.
Running the board for a satellite television on DirecTV station, 8-hour daily programming.
Oh, board op.
Yeah, I was doing technical behind the scenes.
It's pretty impressive. You were on the Maury Povich show, and you were an intern.
You know how to fix phones for the...
I was an intern, you're correct, but I also had a paying job running a board after I was done with my internship.
Mm-hmm. All right. See?
Hey,
she's
see?
Doing things. And now...
running a board. She didn't say it was from Home Depot, though, did she?
Stop.
No, she was out of the business.
Hey.
Hold the whole thing together.
What was that?
Are you going to try to sue these guys and get like some of the like the rights to the photos, or at least get some of the website money back?
That'd be something. No, you're fine with those being out there. Now, being a mother, aren't you concerned that maybe your children will look on the web and see some of these pictures of you?
No, because when they're old enough, I'll have a talk with them about it. Like I said,
yeah,
I have no shame and I have no guilt. It's the bottom line.
Yeah,
I'm going to be open and honest.
I just know how excited some children can get if they see things on the web like that. You know, all of a sudden they're looking and, you know, they're...
Well, hopefully they're not going to be looking at areas like
something.
That. There's parental blocker that you can put on your computer.
Two of them are going to look at and one of them's trying to eat the monitor.
Do you realize that you were known for your big, juicy tits and that's it?
I don't really care.
Yeah, that was a point in her life. That was a point in her life, Opie.
That was a point in my life where that's what mattered, I guess.
And she moved beyond it.
No longer that way.
She's moved beyond it. It happens. I mean, you do something. Sometimes you're young and foolish.
I'm sure you have a few skeletons in your closet there, Opie.
Yeah, absolutely.
Hey, he certainly
touché,
does.
Touché, Tawny.
I'm sure there's a few big-headed skeletons in his closet.
Actually, I'm sure there are, and that's fine.
Actually,
luckily, yours just aren't all over there on the web.
Yep,
absolutely. She made a couple decisions that...